Hey Libra, it's Yvonne here from the Aussie Goddess, here to do your weekly read from the 24th to the 30th of September. Thank you very much for subscribing to my channel and welcome on board. Thank you for anyone returning and thank you for your beautiful comments. If you haven't subscribed to me yet, I'd love to have you here. Please subscribe. If my readings don't resonate with you, however, I'm happy for you to move on. You can also check out other aspects of your natal sign, of your natal chart. I say that every time. But your moon, your Venus, and your rising or ascendant are very important. And sometimes one will resonate more with you than the rest. Cards I'm using are the Julia Massaglia After Tarot. If you would like to find out more about me or would like a personal reading, details are below. And only other thing I need to say is the October readings are now up if you want to have a look at those. Beautiful, we're ready to go. One more. Oh, the cards are a bit lively, Libra. Haven't had that today, really. Okay, first, oh, that's why. Ta-da! So we have the Lovers. That's awesome. That's the first time I've seen it in the overall energy. Nice energy for the week, Libra. I don't know what you've got on your plate, but it looks like there may be a huge choice in regards to love here. Okay, let's see how it unfolds. First card out is the Page of Wands. Now, straight off, I would think that you're going to get a very passionate message from someone here. Definitely feels like, oops, I'm just moving things around. Definitely feels like you're about to get a message from someone, and it's passionate. It's something to do with, I don't know, could be love or could be work, but it's definitely something passionate coming your way. Could be an offer of sex with just a wand like that too. Sorry. I just thought about that. Okay, next card out is the Moon. Now, the Moon talks about not having all the information. It can be the card of Cancer or Pisces too. Somehow or another, this message that's coming through either is a little cryptic, it's not very straightforward, or the person has ulterior motives. So just be a little cautious about how you move forward with this. Because to me, I'm drawn to the other person in the card here, and I'm worrying that someone's making contact with you and not telling you about another party. I'll see as we go, but that's my feeling here. But definitely something's hidden. Not everything's in the light at the moment. Okay. Oh. See how, you know, your energy's there. The energy's there before I even pick up the cards. So we've already sussed out there's a sneaky energy here, and then I get this card. Not always is this card sneaky, but I'm sorry, this time it is. Something sneaky is going on here. So I'm asking you, if you have a message from someone asking you to go out, do something, whatever, if you want to do that, that's entirely up to you. But if you're not sure, just check, because I feel like there's someone else in the picture on this. And I'm not usually a person who pipes up and says that either, but it's so obvious here. Now, it could be that there's an ex in the picture and the person hasn't quite got rid of their ex and they're still in their energy. So please don't jump on me for that, because sometimes when we break up with people, even though we physically move on, that person might stay in our energy for a while. That's why we have to grieve. So if we move on too quickly and we haven't gone through the grieving process, that person's energy stays with us for a while. Now, other times you move on from someone, but they still sit in your memory. And it could be that. But because I've got this card here, I'm just saying, just be a little cautious and ask the questions. You may not get the right answers either, because this card is, you know, one of a bit of a liar and sneak. And I don't know that you'll get the answers you want, but please be cautious. Okay, and the next card out is the Star. Now, the Star can talk about healing. We see this, it can be this card of Aquarius, but we see this woman washing away her, you know, sins and whatever else in this water here. So it is a card of healing, but it's also a card of a wish coming true. And I feel like you've been waiting for this person to return. You've been waiting for this person to come in. It feels like a return. And I feel like now they've come in, you're not sure whether to trust them or not. So I feel that this is a wish for you, and you might be so consumed by that that you fail to see what else is going on. So make sure you've got your eyes open, Libra. Okay, and then we have the Empress. Now the Empress talks, this could be, because often the Empress talks about us being fertile. So be very careful if you're going to have any sort of sexual encounter with this person, please, because it's time of pregnancy. But also, this is how you're feeling, you see. So I feel like this, you're ripe, like you're ready to meet someone, you're ready to move on something. You're ready to bring someone into your life. You're very much in this, you know, beautiful, natural, loving energy. Whether you're male or female, it doesn't matter. This loving energy is all around you. So whoever this is coming in, you need to be very careful before you move on with them. So, okay, holy dooly, what a reading. So again, lots of major arcanas. So if you're dealing with a Pisces, I think Pisces, there was a few readings today that had a lot of major arcanas in them. So we have the Tower coming in here. So if you're going to start thinking you're going to build this relationship with someone, the universe is going to break it down. They or you are not ready for this relationship. One of you isn't ready for this relationship. It's built on a faulty foundation. And everything I said at the beginning of the reading before I uncovered it, I said to you, I feel like something's hidden here. There's possibility someone else is still in the picture. There's a possibility somebody's not telling you all the truth. And this just confirms it now. Because for some of you out there, the universe is saying, no, this isn't ready. It's not time. This person's moved before they've done their healing. They still have their ex in their energy. Even if they've, you know, separated from the person they were with, they've not healed. They need to go back to this star energy and do some healing because they're not ready for a relationship and they're trying to push something before the timing is in. Okay, and then we have the Five of Pentacles. Now, this situation is going to leave you feeling like you're out in the cold now because it's like this person's come back into your life when you've really wanted them back. You've really wanted to start something up with them and now it's sort of all crumbled underneath you. And you're going to be feeling a bit sad. But don't despair because I actually think this person is going to come back. I don't think they're ready. I think they've rushed without doing their healing. But I think in the star, they are actually meant for you. But it's just that they've tried to come back too quickly. So let's see if it clarifies a bit more of that. That's the Filiere. See? Again. Universe, you're amazing. Amazing. This person is your love. But they are not ready for this relationship at the moment. They haven't healed from the last one. They're trying to come back to you before they've released the energy of the last person. And the universe is going to bring in a Tower moment because they need to do this healing. They cannot be with you until they're healed. I knew that was coming. Wow. Okay, Ten of Pentacles here. So this is a destined relationship. There is destiny here. It's a relationship that has been built to last. It's just that the other person hasn't done the work. For you, it looks to me like you've done the work because you're feeling very Five of Pentacles now because you feel like you've lost. You feel like you've lost or been rejected or whatever it is, but it's not. It's about them going back to heal before they can be with you. You're ready, but this is why this star energy is here as well before the Tower and the Empress and the Moon, because it's like they've come in too soon. They've rushed out of this other relationship. They've had the epiphany that you're the one they want to be with and they've rushed in, but they haven't dealt with the last lot of shit yet. And the universe is going to say, right, go back, buddy, back off, do your work before you come back in again. And you're not to come back until the work is done. So it'll be interesting to see how that happens, yeah. And then we have communication. So please, Libras, don't give up on this. Let them go. Let them deal with their Tower energy, whatever happens here for you, because you're in the right place. You're here. You're ready for a relationship. They are so not ready. They are so not ready, and that's why the tower's being brought in. It's not you, it's them that need to do this healing. That's why the Seven of Swords, look, he's looking at the healing card here. It's him that needs to be doing the healing. And if you're a woman, and sorry, if you're a man and this is a woman, then you might be ready. You're in this sort of Empress energy where you're ready for love. She's not. So what happens now is you have to wait for this communication. And this communication will come in when they've done their healing, and it will be true love. Bang! How cool is that reading? Oh, wow. Libra, that's amazing. Good story. Good story. Very nice. Ooh. Okay, and the card we've got here is Judgment. Soul searching will bring inner peace to many areas of your life. So you know what, Libra? You go back and you just improve yourself even further. You go back and you do even more improvements, because this person comes back to you with true love. Thanks, Libra.